I'm going to hand over to Dame Susan Devoy and Nermai Hagema.
Ngā mihi nui, ngā mihi mahana, kia koutou katoa. Kia ora whai aroha. I'm very, I'm somewhat overwhelmed by that introduction. Often I go and speak to schools and nobody has any idea what I did. And they look at me and they think, how on earth could someone that looks that old ever have been a world champion? So I am very privileged that you took the time to put those pictures when I was much younger, of course. Not that I'm egotistical in any way, but to just show that that was a very important part of my life. You know, I was very fortunate. Like your kapa haka tutor, I believe, who's from Rotorua?
East Coast.
Oh, well, I was going to say all the good people come from Te Arawa, from Rotorua, but I was really lucky. You know, I was just like any one of you sitting in this room. I was born with a talent, and I was given every opportunity to use it. And many of you here will have many talents. They may not just be sporting, they may come from a whole wide range of different areas. And what I would say to you is, if you really love something, I loved playing squash. I wish I'd played tennis or golf, because then I'd be really loaded. I'd have lots of money and I wouldn't, I'd probably have to get a job. But if you're really passionate about something, then I think you owe it to yourself just to see how far you can go. We can't all be world champions, but we can all be world champions in our own grade. And for me, passion's not just about loving something. Passion's actually about having to make real sacrifices in your life to achieve whatever goals you set. But I'm here today in my role as Race Relations Commissioner because part of my role is to foster harmonious relations, which means to do what I can in my position to ensure that as New Zealanders, we all get along. And I think on a monthly basis, I acknowledge different groups of peoples or individuals that do magnificent things that celebrate who we are and what it means to be a New Zealander. And it was mentioned to me and has been talked about in the commission because I know that Holly's sons go to this school. I'm not sure if there's one or two, and one's in the Kapa Haka group. And it was acknowledged that here at this school, your kapa haka group is something significant because not only does it promote and preserve our own Māori culture, but it is inclusive of everyone. And that's really what I'm here today for, is to acknowledge your kapa haka group, to acknowledge whai aroha, who I'm told and believe, and that's why I sent that really nice email, is one of life's real treasures. You know, one of those people that we, that is like the glue in our community that binds and keeps us together. So when I went to school in Rotorua, I would say that in my class, if I was sitting here in my class, we would have been predominantly Pākehā and Māori. We might have had one or two Chinese, I think, growing up through my entire school, but that was really it. And if I look 30 years on, probably a bit longer than that, 40 years on. And if I asked how many people in this room were not born in New Zealand, a number of you would probably put your hands up, or if your parents weren't born in New Zealand. So we are now a culture, a country of many, many different cultures. And that's part of my role, because I go to schools and people talk about children being our future. And that's really important, but children are also our present. And when I go to schools and I see the diversity out there in this hall, and I see the, I see and hear all the wonderful things going on, I think our country is in good heart. So what we need to understand is that, let's think of the things that bind us together rather than things that make us different. You know, and my role is to ensure that all New Zealanders never judge people by the colour of their skin, their appearance, their religious beliefs, or the fact that they are different from you or I. And so I just would really like to acknowledge the entire school for the efforts that you make. And I think when I come to the school and I look at the Kapahaka group, who are not only outstanding performers but so beautifully in their costumes, looking absolutely wonderful, I just want to say thank you for all that you do in helping our country. The theme for this year for Race Relations Day, Race Relations Day, was I am Aotearoa New Zealand. And so we ask people, what does it mean to be a New Zealander? And for me, having being a Pākehā and being born here, I've never ever felt that I didn't fit in or I didn't belong. And I know, and I talk to lots of people, that everyday racism does exist. And just as I saw when I came to the school here, you had something on your, in fact, I must learn to Twitter, because then I could Twitter you. I see you're on Twitter as well. But there was something there about bullying. And recently we had Pink Shirt Day, and I was over at Henderson Intermediate, actually. And that's what it's all about, is people like yourself standing up and being counted. Just as we don't accept or tolerate bullies, we also don't tolerate or accept when people say nasty things about each other because they might be different from you and I. But I don't think I need to worry about that here. I think you are a school that's probably modelling that every day. So, kia ora whaeronga. It's a real privilege to be here. And thank you very much for the effort that you do for your kapahaka group and for all of you young people out there. And, you know, whaeronga was right. The most important thing in my life is my family. You know, I've got four sons. When I retired and stopped hitting that little ball around the court, I had four sons. So they're now 20, 19, 18, and 16. I've got six brothers and no sisters, and now I've got four sons and no daughters. So that means I've been punished for all the terrible things I've said about men in my life, I think. But, you know, really, they are the most important part of my life, is family and whānau is to all of us. So, and on the way here, my son, who's coming up to Auckland today, I'm meeting with him, he's collecting those rugby league cards. Do you know what they are, those rugby league cards? Does anyone know what they are? At 16 years of age, he said, Mum, I've just googled the map and Henderson's really near Avondale and I bought some cards on Trade Me, and would you mind paying for them and going picking them up on your way home from Henderson? So, you know, mothers still do have their uses. But kia ora koutou, and thank you very much for the privilege of being here today. Cheers.